hardest part is figuring out what you want to master.
Focus on your product.
Can you tell somebody that they suck?
You gotta just go for
this
it.
Is exactly what I want to do for a living.
You can't even tell somebody that their breath is life.
All right, we're back. The clock is on. Charlie, welcome back. 10-Minute Mondays.
Woo! Ten minutes.
We got 10 minutes. The clock is ticking. We got to give some sort of gem or inspirational piece of content for all of these people to start their week off. And we're going to do it. This is what I want to ask you about.
Okay.
You posted this photo on your Instagram. It says influencers versus influential people. It's on a whiteboard, hand-drawn. Mm. On the left side, you have influencers, which is saying, I'm perfect. I'm rich. I'm so successful. I'm different than you. Then on the right side, you have people like Michael Jordan, Oprah, The Rock, Steve Harvey, and you have, you know, I was cut from my high school basketball team. I struggle with my weight. I had $7 left in my bank account. These are people who are just like you. So obviously when I look, it doesn't take a genius. When I look at this whiteboard, I see that this is, you're kind of mentioning everything that's annoying about influencers and social media culture. And on the right, you're naming some of the biggest, most influential people of ever.
Yes.
Can you explain to me what the difference is, what we are learning here,
100%.
And how people can strive to be more influential and not influencers?
100%. So this whiteboard is the most viral post I've ever had.
Yeah, rightfully so.
It struck a chord, and it's a sign of what is to come on social media. Social media 1.0 is coming to an absolute end. People are sick and tired of what they're seeing. Yeah. At one time on the internet, we used to click banners with the little target that went back and forth, and then we got smart and like, yeah, that's, we don't want that anymore.
That's a trick.
The same thing has happened on social media. Everybody is saying, I'm so perfect.
Yep.
I'm so successful. I'm so rich. That's why you should follow me. But I made a discovery. I've always kind of had this gift of like being able to see around the corner of culture, like where things are going to go next.
Yep.
And I'm noticing these things. And it all actually started with Spider-Man. I was doing business research. What is the number one grossing superhero franchise of all time? Pulled up Spider-Man. And I'm asking myself the question, why is Spider-Man number one over Batman, over Superman, over everybody?
Yep.
He's the only one that doesn't have muscles. He's the only one that doesn't have a chiseled chin. Mm-hmm. His aunt couldn't pay the rent and was getting evicted. The only superhero that's having everyday problems.
Yeah.
We can relate the most to him. Is that why he's number one? So then I thought about it. Michael Jordan has this place in our hearts because he gave us a story that no other basketball player who's great has ever given us.
Yep.
He says, I got cut from my high school basketball team. I was scrawny. I couldn't beat my brother in basketball growing up. All these things sat in our heart that could make us relate to him. And if we're talking about marketing in the debate of Michael Jordan versus LeBron James, Michael Jordan has this theme song with Gatorade called Be Like Mike. Yep. It goes, sometimes I dream that he is me. And then when you're watching the commercial, the ball hits him in the head.
Yeah.
And he's playing with the kids. But then on the flip side, you've got King James, who's saying, I'm the king. I'm on top.
And in his back, he has chosen one.
Chosen one, yeah. Exactly. Which is fine, but that means you're saying, I'm nothing like you.
Yeah.
And if you look at Kobe Bryant, who's now almost even out of the debate, and if you want to see why, Kobe Bryant's the Black Mamba.
Yeah.
Kobe Bryant is the most intense. He's alone. These snakes, a Black Mamba is a snake, and they're alone. He's in the gym by himself, intense, drip sweating. Michael Jordan's on the playground with the kids. The ball hits him in the head, laughing that he messed up.
Yeah.
The song is, if I could be like Mike, fun, playful, us, I got cut. Boom, look at Oprah, the most influential woman in the world. She says, I'm still struggling with my weight. Like, it's so relatable.
Yep.
She's not trying to be perfect. Now, yes, she does extraordinary things. Everybody is, we all should strive to be extraordinary, but we should all learn to be authentic and tell the truth. Like right now, if I were to do this I am you theory with marketing or building like a cult following on social media, if you want to be influential, truly influential, I'd say something like this. I'd be like, well, you know, I'm a little overweight. Yep. And I'm not going to lie to you. Under this hoodie, I'm a man, but I'm wearing a Spanx.
Uh-huh.
Like, I don't know of any man who's ever talked about, yeah, I wear Spanx. Yeah. I wear Spanx. Yeah. But there's going to be people out there, and if I put this on social media right now,
yep,
that, yeah, like, I'm a little embarrassed coming on your show, being on camera, so I wear the compression shirt to kind of, like, make me look skinnier.
Yeah.
If I put that on social media, it would get 10 times the engagement a normal post would of me just sitting here like I'm doing a podcast.
Yep.
People appreciate the honesty because they're relatable. Now, some people out there might be thinking to themselves, well, if I'm telling people how regular I am, how does that make me stand out?
Yeah.
I tell them, nobody's talking the truth.
Yeah.
So you stand out just by telling the truth.
Yeah.
So this is how I believe social media 2.0, where it's going, yeah, with building your brand, with building influence. We saw Domino's do it. Yeah. Domino's turned their entire company around by being honest. They said stock was tanking, company was failing. They came out and said, we messed up. Uh-huh. We know our pizza tastes like cardboard.
Uh-huh.
We're going to bring all natural ingredients in. We're going to use real ingredients, mm-hmm, and we're going to turn this around.
Mm-hmm.
They did a commercial,
yeah,
about honesty. They turned it around. It went viral.
Yeah.
Now the pizza tastes good.
Yep.
It was honest. And then when I looked at it, does this hold true with like a product or like a corporation, just in general marketing terms? Yep. What's the biggest corporation in the world? Apple.
Yep.
Who's the CEO? Steve Jobs, who blew it up.
Yep.
He was the first CEO that was just like us.
Yeah.
He didn't have the suit on. He wasn't sitting in Mahogany Row. He wasn't trying to be some boss. He wore, you know, the New Balance shoes,
yeah,
the turtleneck. He looked like my dad.
Yeah.
That's why when he passed away, people loved him. He was the first CEO that was a regular guy, yeah, going up against the machine. His commercials were so empowering of the people.
Yep.
Everything was about the people. He had this commercial, I think it was 1980, you know, four or, yeah, something, where, you know, it's like the big dictator.
Yep.
IBM. He used like a metaphor.
Yep.
There was a screen with a dictator on it. There were all these people marching.
Yep.
And this girl with a red dress throws the sledgehammer at the screen. And this is symbolic that Apple is here for the people.
Yep.
And he would name his products Lisa, Macintosh, human names. Not Inspiron 3000,
yep,
but human names. It was just like us.
Yeah.
iPod.
Yeah.
Just like us, iPhone, just like us. This I am you theory is stop trying to say how different than you are than everybody else.
Yeah.
Yes, do amazing things, but be honest and watch your influence increase, watch your following increase, and watch people's hearts start singing for you, and that will change your company. That will change the trajectory of everything. If you want some examples, follow my Instagram. I do it all the time.
Yep.
I'm just honest.
So I think that the majority of my listeners probably either are trying to build a following for their business, mm-hmm, or, you know, maybe secretly or not so secretly wish they had more of a following so that maybe they could get in the game a little bit, is what we're telling them on this Monday to start their week, to start mastering the art of vulnerability and 100%. Honesty and talk about the rough morning and talk about how hard it was to get into the gym. And that's one thing that 100%. I really love about you, right? I follow a lot of entrepreneurs, business people, artists, whatever, whatever. You keep it real. You tell me when it's a, mm-hmm, rough day in the gym. You, mm-hmm, tell me when you've had the 2 weeks ago you were in a bad spot and you, mm-hmm, couldn't get out of bed, even though you're this guy that's like the face of health and change, mm-hmm, and you're very honest about that stuff, and that's why I connect with you so much. But is that what we're saying? We're saying master the art of that.
Bro, let me tell you, it changed my life.
Mm-hmm.
I made a fan-made I Am You Theory Nike commercial,
yep,
where I was just honest about my story because I believed Nike needed a common man athlete,
yep,
somebody who was just like everybody. I made the commercial. We put it out. It went viral. Nike calls me and said, you showing us that common men athlete is important to this world,
yep,
inspired us to take the company in that direction. That's where the Colin Kaepernick commercial came from. And this year, Because of that fan-made Nike commercial, Nike platformed over 200 alternative common athletes, people without legs who are in wheelchairs that play basketball. You saw it all throughout the Colin Kaepernick commercial. But that IMU theory shifted all of culture, and Nike adopted it. So when people start doing this on social media, watch brand deals open up. Watch all sorts of things change.
Yeah. Okay, so we got, should I just end it there? No, let me do this. Okay, so we have 30 seconds left. What can we tell people to do this week? Can we say post 5 Instagram story posts of honesty and you overcoming something that is difficult for you this week and tag us?
Take people on a journey, because we're all trying to go somewhere. We're all trying to accomplish something.
Yep.
So send people on a journey like, I'm starting my business. It's not doing well.
Yep.
This is what I'm going through. Like, be honest, and then people are going to look at you as a genius when you come overcome it. They'll be like, man, I remember when you were struggling. But yes, tag us, tag at Charlie, tag at Drama, and just be honest and watch what happens.
Yep.
Everything changes.
There it is. Happy Monday, guys. 10-minute Monday.
Let's go.
Done.
Guys, if you like that and you want to see more like it, as well as vlogs, other web series, and all the random stuff that I'm doing here on YouTube, don't forget to click that subscribe button. You won't regret it. I promise.